seconds. He's like, 1 second. He's like,
what's up, guys?
What's up? How are you?
I'm doing well.
That's great.
This is a national convention vlog. It'll be on YouTube. No, I'm just kidding. I don't know. We'll see.
How's your day going?
I'm doing good. How are you guys?
Good.
Solid.
Good. So far.
Holy, made in glory.
like I said, I'm Grayson. I'm from Oklahoma. And I'm actually going to be singing a song that I wrote. And basically, I wrote it from this place of about a year ago, I was feeling basically completely unredeemable. If you saw the top 10, you've already heard my explanation for the song, but it's I was feeling completely unredeemable, basically. Unworthy of everything that I had, everything that I could have. I thought that was going to be how it was forever. And there was this moment during worship where I was trying to lift my hands. I saw other people around me raising their hands and going all in, and I said, I can't do that. And right as all these feelings started to overwhelm me, it was so clear. I remember it very, very vividly. It was God, through one of the people around me, he said, Grayson, I love you so much. And I was confused in the very best way possible. I was so confused. And that's what this song's about. It's called Human. I really hope you guys like it.
The next senators.
The next vice president.
The next president.
The only question is,
who are they?
Welcome to election returns. Good evening, TeenPact Nation. Welcome back to the final broadcast of TeenPact Network News. I am Jake Myers.
And I am Evie Erickson. The long-awaited night is finally here. The hard work of the past few months comes down to now. Tonight we learn what administration will be leading the TeenPact Nation in 2022.
Throughout the night, we will receive the Electoral College votes from each state. We will also be receiving word on who was selected to represent you as representative and senator throughout the segment. Along the way, we will interview several guests, watch commercials from our sponsors, and eventually hear from your newly elected officials.
And it now looks like we are receiving the name of the first representative-elect of this evening.
I genuinely don't know, but if there's one thing that you can take away from my campaign and all of my time running, I would say please remember that it is most important to be still, because our relationship with God is first and foremost most important.
Amen.
One last time, my name is Brad.
Your hard work has truly paid off.
We are now receiving results from our next state, home of the weirdest dichotomy in sports history, with the best basketball team and the worst football team, Kansas.
Kansas doesn't even have a best football team.
Yeah!
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 Congratulations to Smith George. Coming into this week, Kansas was largely untouched by any of these three campaign teams. George lacked any significant campaign team members from the state yet, and we can only assume why, they were able to pull off a close victory in the Jayhawk state.
And we are now receiving results from our next state, the state of Maine. Strong correlation between success in this year's election and having a last name that sounds like it should be a first name. Megan Nelson and Daniel Nelson have both found success in this year's election with double first names. This trend is only magnified with the success of the people like Luke Wilson, Tom Brady, LeBron James, Michael Jordan, Moto Moto, the hippopotamus from the hit animated film.
The name of the next representative nominee.
This is just straight out.
You are the voters.
You have decided.
Sitting among you are the next representatives.
The next senators.
The next vice president.
The next president.